Hello everyone, welcome to another tutorial on Vector in Motion. Today we are going to learn truss analysis using the method of joints. What is a truss? Truss is a structure that is designed to support loads over a long span. This is the span of this truss which you see here on your screen, and these are the different loads spread over the structure. Now, what are the components of a truss? Truss consists of slender, thin, straight members. These are bars which are usually called members, and different members are joined together at the ends with a pin. So these are the pins and these are the different members. In doing truss analysis, we actually determine the internal forces of these different members. So it's a part of the design process of the truss, so that we can then select the right material of right cross section and strength so that it can sustain and endure that kind of internal forces. So in order to determine the internal forces of the members, we make certain assumptions, and those assumptions are: one, the weight of the members is much smaller in comparison to the loads, and therefore we ignore the weight of the members. And number two, the members are connected with frictionless pins so that there are no frictional forces involved. And three, the external loads are always applied at the pins. You don't have a situation of the load getting applied at some midpoint of a member. No, this is incorrect. So loads are applied always at the pins. So these are the three assumptions, and these assumptions lead us to conclude that these members act like two force bodies, two force members. I have made two videos on two force members, and I suggest you take a look at them and understand the basic properties of two force members when they are in equilibrium. The basic property of the two force members is that they can sustain only axial forces, and the axial forces can either be tensile or compressive. So this member between the two pins A and B is shown here, and this member can be either in tension or in compression. When it is in tension, the forces are stretching the member, and when it is in compression, the forces are in this direction, so that they are squeezing this member. The corresponding forces on the pins A and B are shown like this. The force on pin B is in a direction opposite to this force. These two forces are in fact action-reaction pairs as per Newton's third law. The point that you have to keep in mind is that when the member is in tension, the force acting on the pin is pointing away from the pin. Same is the case at pin A at the other end of the member. The force here is pointing away from the pin. But when the member is in compression, the force on the pin is towards the pin. On both the pins A and B, the forces are towards the pin. This is an important aspect that should be kept in mind. Okay? To determine the reaction forces at the supports, we make FBD of the entire truss. Because we had a roller support at point A, we just have one reaction force acting in vertical direction, AY. And because we had a pin support at pin H, we have two forces, HY and HX, in vertical and horizontal direction. So we have to determine these three forces using the equilibrium equation. So when we use our first equation, summing the forces in x direction, we conclude that this force is 0, Hx is 0. Next, we sum the forces in y direction, and that gives us Ay plus Hy equal to sum of all these forces, which is 12 kilonewtons. And next, we determine the moment of all these forces about point A. So these two forces will not contribute any moment about point A. The load forces at point B, D, F and H would cause clockwise moment, while the reaction force HY will cause anti-clockwise moment, and the moment arm for these forces are 4 meters, 8 meters, 12 and 16 meters. So we have this equation which has HY as unknown, and that will work out to 6 kilonewtons. We substitute this value of 6 kilonewtons here, we get the value of AY as 6 kilonewtons. So we have HY as 6 kilonewtons, AY is also 6 kilonewtons, and HX is 0. Now we will turn our attention to the individual pins, and we'll be making free body diagram of the pins. Here is a diagram that shows all the forces acting on each and every pin of the truss. The forces in black color are the forces acting on the pins due to the interaction with the members of the truss. We make an assumption that all the members of the truss are initially in tension. So the forces acting on the pins are in a direction pointing away from the pin. So you see all the black colored forces at each and every pin pointing away from the pin. This diagram will clarify the point. This is the member between the pins A and B, and the forces acting on the member are tensile. The forces at each end have the same magnitude, FAB. Now these two forces, black colored forces, are acting on the pins A and B, and their magnitude also is FAB. And these are the two forces which have been shown here. Okay. Now question is, at which pin should we begin our equilibrium analysis? The answer is that we could start either at pin A or pin H. The reason is that at both of these pins, only two members are connected to the pins. Here there are two members connected to pin A, and here too, only two members are connected to pin H. In this particular case, we'll begin with pin A, determine these two unknown forces, and then proceed to the adjacent pins, and one by one we'll take up each of the pin and determine the internal forces of each and every member. Okay. So we draw a detailed FBD of pin A here, and that will enable us to write the equilibrium equations. As you can see, this is the load force, this is the reaction force, and these two forces, FAB and FAC, are the forces acting on the pin due to the tension in the members AB and AC. The slope of the member is 3 meters over 4, so it's a 3 upon 4. Because these are all concurrent forces, and therefore there are no moments involved, so there is no moment equation. So we have just these two equations, and therefore we shall be able to solve only two unknowns. So in y direction, we have 6 minus 1.5 plus the y component of force FAB, that would be FAB times 3 upon 5, and sum of all these forces equal to 0, which is this equation, and when simplified will yield FAB equal to minus 7.5 kilonewtons. What does the negative sign mean? The negative sign here means that our assumption that the member AB is under tension, that assumption is incorrect, and in reality the member AB is in compression, and therefore we have the negative sign here. The second equation, sigma FX equal to 0, will mean FAC plus FAB times 4 upon 5 will be equal to 0, and putting in the value of minus 7.5 kilonewtons in place of FAB will give us FAC equal to 6 kilonewtons. And because this is a positive answer, means that our assumption that this member AC is under tension is correct. So we have found the two internal forces of the members, AB and AC. AB in reality is under compression and AC is under tension. Now we should be updating this diagram by reversing the direction of these two forces, and therefore it will look like this. So we have flipped the direction of the force FAB, and now it is pointing towards the pin at A as well as at pin B. And we write C here to denote that this member is under compression. We could have written the magnitude of the force also here, but since the diagram will look very cluttered, we write it separately here as 7.5 kilonewtons and within bracket C, denoting that it is a compressive force. FAC is 6 kilonewtons and it's a tensile force. Therefore, we write T here and we write T here on our diagram. Okay? So now we can proceed to an adjacent pin and carry out a similar equilibrium analysis. The question is, should we move on to pin B or pin C? The answer is we should not go to pin B, because here we know this force, we know this force, but these three forces are not known, and we shall have only two equilibrium equations for pin B, and therefore we will not be able to solve these three forces. Instead of moving to pin B, we should move from pin A to pin C, where this force is known. This is FAC and that is now known, and there are only two unknowns, FCE and FCB. So here is the FBD of pin C, and we notice that in x direction we have sigma FX equal to 0, that will give us FCE equal to FAC, and therefore this also would be 6 kilonewtons. So this member also is in tension and its value is 6 kilonewtons. In y direction, sigma Fy equal to 0, and that will give FCB equal to 0. So this member is a zero force member. So we shall update our drawing like this. So we write a T here to denote that this member is under tension, and we make a note here that the value of FCE is 6 kilonewtons. And also that FCB is 0, and we write down 0 here to denote that this member is a zero force member. And now the question is, should we proceed to E or proceed to B? The answer is that we should now go to pin B, because now we have just two unknowns, FBD and FBE. These two forces are known, and therefore we shall be able to successfully carry out the equilibrium analysis of pin B. Okay? This is the FBD of pin B. The force FAB is pointing towards the pin because we found that member AB is under compression. The slope of this force is 3 over 4, and that of force FBD is 1 meter over 4 meters, so it's 1 over 4, and that of force FBE is 3 over 4. Note that these two forces are pointing away from the pin because these two members are under tension as per our earlier assumption. Now we apply the equations of equilibrium. Sigma FX equal to 0 would mean FAB times 4 upon 5 plus FBD times 4 upon square root 17 plus FBE times 4 upon 5 equal to 0. Okay? This equation, which on simplification will look like this. So this is our first equation. And now we write the equilibrium equation in y-axis, and that will be 7.5, which is FAB, times 3 upon 5 plus FBD times 1 upon square root 17 minus FBE times 3 upon 5 minus 3 equal to 0. And that will simplify to this equation. This is our equation number 2. And now we find that we have two equations, simultaneous equations in two unknowns, FBD and FBE. The coefficients of FBE in the first equation is 4 upon 5 and that in the second equation is minus 3 upon 5. So we multiply the first equation by 3 and this equation by 4 and add the 2. FBE would get cancelled and we'll be left with FBD times 16 upon square root 17 equal to minus 24. And that will give us FBD equal to minus 6.19 kilonewtons. And here again, the negative sign indicates that the force FBD is compressive. We plug in this value in second equation and that will give us FBE equal to 0. Okay? So the force in member FBD is compressive and this is a zero force member. So let's update this diagram. So we write C here to indicate that this is a compressive force and flip the direction of the forces. And since this is a zero force member, we write 0. So we have found internal forces of 6 of the members. And question is, should we proceed to pin number D or E? Or wait a sec. We should have noticed this earlier that this truss is symmetrical about this vertical line. So this is the line of symmetry. The left hand side of the truss is identical to the truss on the right hand side. Even the loading is identical on both the side. So due to symmetry, the internal forces of this member would be same as what it is in member AB. Similarly, the internal force in the member DF would be same as what it is in DB. And the members FG and EF would also be zero force members. So because of symmetry of the truss and the loading, we can deduce that the internal forces on the right hand side are same as what they are here on the left hand side. And now we can draw the FBD of pin E and find that there are only three forces acting on this pin. And therefore, by applying this equation, we find that FED also is zero, which means the member DE is also a zero force member. So this listing gives the internal forces of all the members and that's our answer. Thanks for watching and if you like the video, please give your thumbs up and if you're new to the channel, please subscribe. Thanks for watching again. See you in the next video.